In this scene, me and Muhammad run to get the first aid kits, that is, with the other group, because one of the scouts had a fatality. What happens next is shocking.
We need the first aid kit. Nabil, you good?
Yeah.
Or I should say better? Someone else got hurt.
I have
no idea, but someone asked for the first aid kit.
So when you see the bridge, there's a little bridge thing, two wooden bridges thing. Take that, go to Barry Gulch.
Alright?
Thank you.
Yep.
We can still make it. This is a cool bridge.
Yeah, it's nice.
Delivery.
Someone needed it.
Is this not
the first
one?
This is.
The daddy client?
That's what I was gonna say also. I'm gonna send two scouts, two sets of scouts back.
I did, but like.
Aaron, how far are the other scouts?
I think they're very up for them.
I don't know.
Because I don't see them from here at all.
Run.
We don't need to run no more.
Yeah, who needs the first aid kit? No, who needs it? Someone needs the first aid kit, right?
Guys, 5 minute break.
Oh my god.
5 minutes?
Did no one need the first aid kit?
Alright, my dad.
Oh my god, we ran so much.
Kareem, go back.
We ran an entire journey just to think that somebody was gonna need it, and no one needed it. I recorded the entire incident, yeah.
Okay. You recorded the whole journey?
Yes! Were you the one who needed it?
Oh
No, I was just asking for it because I thought we lost it.
Oh my god, you are unbelievable, Hunza.
I never told you that to go.
Oh my god. Alright, so Fahim, why are you so sweaty? I was carrying an armada of a backpack. You have to see how big this thing is. And I lasted like as long as you did.
Me?
Yes.
Hey. Well, alright, but why were we running?
To deliver the first aid kit.
Okay, is everyone fine?
Yes, and we ran for no reason.
Hey, let's go.
Okay, we're about to enter this cave. Yeah, all the way back there.
Oh yeah, they thought the stock market would get bigger and bigger.
My light right here. Yo, this is so good. Oh my god, this is so low. Damn, this is awesome.
Step to the side, guys.
Oh, there's a lot.
Okay.
Oh.
See that?
Whoa.
That's why they put this bridge here, because in the 1930s, how are you going to squeeze through that area, right? You come with this big wall and climb up here.
Wait, but how can you get this bridge?
See? Like right. Right. When you were caving, you had to climb up this
back like
area up through here. Much harder.
Oh, I think I got ahead of you. Let's see.
So, you'd have to climb up here, a caver, had to climb up through this, chimney inside through here, get up on this, and then climb out that way.
So now you need no skills to get here.
Right, now you just, you know, your grandma can hike it. Yeah, okay, so this goes nowhere, but we can come out and see that. So you can go either way. But that's a better trail, but I don't know if you want to come and look here and just take a look. But this is cramped.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my
probably
god.
Not going to fit.
What happened?
No, a bomb went off. That was the fuse.
Oh god.
This is the squeeze. Before we got to the caves, that little trail split apart. One said reservoir this way, one said reservoir by the caves. So here's where you go around. If you go this way, you don't go through the caves. So normally when we rock climb, we got all this gear, we don't go through this.
Nice.
But we're skilled.
No, I don't think
so.
The people in 1930 are the skilled ones. We're all unfit.
No, I think that's the good one from the game. Look at this.
What?
My bottle opened when I put it in my pocket.
Oh, wow.
Come on, man. Well,
it doesn't count as wetting yourself if it's not your own piss.
Nah, you just
fun fact, so that's the We're adventuring down from here. Oh my god! His water bottle.
Get back in the middle. Hang on to the left.
Where? Here?
Yeah, like this.
Don't
hit
him. I won't hit my head
again. Wait, is it just me or does Aeon? Aeon look like a mini Hamad.
He does. He is.
Who's Hamad?
Hamad. Look at that one tree down there. It's orange.
Well, if we get lost and we don't get to the
rock, I blame you.
Platform there that they built up a couple years ago.
Wait, I'm going to take a photo of you.
Fahim, bro, please don't.
Yo, Talha, start recording.
This is Fahim's job. Pro vlogger.
Oh, yes, some rock climbing shoes.
What is he saying?
happened.
You know the reason.
He's like, hey, look down. Come on, your hands are
up. Can you like pull this off?
No, that's where your foot's gonna go. Why are your foot's gonna go?
I think it's tight, so.
Backwards?
Good job, but here go.
No, it's not. It's upside down.
Alright, I think I did do it right on the
I can't, but it's the camera you need to let you.
Wait, turn it off.
I believe, oh, nah. We can write our story. I believe we can be
amazing. We are the warriors who learn to love the pain. We come from different places. Okay, now grab those hands on the rope, lean back. Outstanding! Good job! That's the way you do it, guys!
Right away.
Look at that!
Look at me! Jump! Be a frog! Jump! Let's go! Yeah! Let's go! That's insane!
Wow! Finally someone who listened to directions!
Here is something funny that happened in the campout when I was sleeping in the tent. And this was a very traumatizing experience based on the location I was in. So one of the blazing bulls left a bowl of pasta and it was burnt extra crispy. And so a whole gang of wild pigs showed up at the campsite. And since I was in the patrol fiery phoenixes, we were on opposite sides. They were on one campsite and we were on the other. And it is very close together. So the pigs were getting aggressive with each other, and I think I heard one of them whine. So there's definitely an alpha in the rankings for sure. And at one point, I thought that I had this thought where they had like big tusks and stuff like that, but I don't know for sure. So they finished the bowl of pasta clean, and they were there for around a solid 20 to 30 minutes, and I did not see them because I was worried that if I made any noise opening the tent window and looking at them, they can hear me and possibly charge down my tent. So I was not really willing to take any risks, and I was frozen solid the entire time, and I could not go to sleep because the pigs were so darn loud. And at one point, my scoutmaster went out of his tent and shooed off the pigs with his headlamp. He was sleeping in the blazing bulls area though, and I was relieved because I did not hear the pigs anymore. And the reason how I know that my scoutmaster shooed off the pigs was because he told us the next morning. So thank you, Brother Steve. He saved me from having an everlasting trauma. And that is why that was a frightening situation, because I thought I was gonna possibly get hurt. And by the way, I was camping in the tent with my good old buddy Shaquille, Thalha, and Amin. But I was the only one awake. I struggled for years and through all of the tears I faced the doubts I hide. I never gave in to my faith, but think as I heard my voice inside. I know I was born for this. I know.